Mattis is meeting his counterpart, South Korean Defense Minister Song Young-moo, and he has renewed their mutual commitment to finding a peaceful solution to the events in the region. Meanwhile, the United Nations Special Rapporteur on North Korea told a Human Rights Committee in New York that the sanctions against North Korea's regime may be hurting the wrong people. For more on this story, we go to journalist Frank Ucciardo. He is at the UN in New York.
The gist of the report from the Special Rapporteur, that being Tomas Quintana, his basic worry was that, okay, the sanctions are very tight, but they may really be hurting innocent people, people that need food, people that need clothing, people that need housing. And he said, you know, he was very specific. He said stuff like, okay, let's talk about the people that need special drugs, such as the cancer drugs. And then I'll call, let's talk about people that need wheelchairs and special medical devices. He said, those are the kind of things that may not be getting through to them because of the Security Council sanctions that are in place. And, you know, the last round of Security Council sanctions came after the September 15th launch a missile by North Korea. So, you know, right now he's getting feedback from the region, and he's saying that you'd have to be careful because you really may be hurting and punishing the wrong people, not just the regime. There's something very interesting that the Chinese have been doing. Basically, they've been sending raw textiles to the north, to North Korean factories. So basically, if they're making, say, a jacket or a dress, they'll have the North Korean workers sew that all together in North Korea using Chinese textiles that are secretly sent to the north. They'll actually, in some cases, sew on a label that says made in China, ship it back to China, and China will ship it around the world. So they've been very inventive in finding ways to kind of skirt the sanctions right now.